Hi, I'm Grant Taft, Executive Director of the American Football Coaches Association. On behalf of the AFCA and NCAA football, I'd like to welcome you to today's game. As players and coaches, we will compete to win, but within the rules of the game. We ask that you do the same by staying off the playing field at all times. We want you to celebrate in victory, but we want you to do so in a safe environment. Taunting is not permitted on the field, and it should not occur in the stands or in the parking lot. Respect your opponent on the field and their fans with the dignity and the courtesy that you and your team would expect. Make it a great day for college football.
Thank you. Anthony Belmonte, DN, education, Wheaton, Illinois.
Corey Flom, defensive line, undecided, probably like Minnesota.
Nick Farkadapain, defensive tackle, business major, total New Jersey.
Zach Davidson, defensive end, criminal justice, Racine, Wisconsin.
Amir Ismail, linebacker, Holland, Michigan, exercise science.
Dustin Duclo, linebacker, computer science major, Southgate, Michigan.
Paul Tiedoff, linebacker, criminal justice, Oakley, Michigan.
Louis Demers, cornerback, business major, Miami, Florida.
Antoine Allen, strong safety, exercise science, Chicago.
CJ Wilson, free safety, family studies, majoring in family studies.
EJ Biggers, cornerback, business major, Miami, Florida.
matching the corner up to make the tackle, but Greg with enough to get that first down. First and 10 Western Michigan from the Cardinals 46-yard line. London Pryor line to the right side. Kelly Martin line to the left side. Broncos direct snap it to Greg Jennings. Jennings hands it off to Kirk Ellsworth. He's inside the 40 to the 39-yard line, and there's the new one out of the playbook.
And there's a flag thrown in here by the umpire. That's going to be a late hit here, I think, on Ball State. I doubt it's on Western Michigan, unless they're calling a hold 10 minutes after the play. But a razzle-dazzle there. Robbie Haas under the center. Then he goes in motion. Greg Jennings is lined up as the tailback. They snap the ball directly to him. Kirk Ellsworth is offset behind the left tackle. They hand the ball to Kirk running left to right. He picks up a big gain of about 6-7 yards here, and we'll find out what the umpire has to say. It's definitely after the whistle. Well, there's the
offsetting personal foul calls, and the play will stand. And the handoff by Jennings to Kirk Ellsworth goes for 7. It's second down and 3, and I imagine that's a read by Greg, whether to give it to Kirk or take it himself. And he handed it to Kirk Ellsworth, and he picks up 8. Now on second down and 3 from the 40-yard line of Ball State. Cardinals jump, and then one of the Bronco linemen rocked after they jumped.
Matt Williams, the left guard there, had a linebacker up in his face, and it wasn't able to sit right in there. Now, if you know, it's probably going to be procedure here on the Bronco.
Matt Williams picks up the 5-yard penalty, brings up the second down and 8 now for Western Michigan. Jennings and Chapel wide to the left side. Home setback is... handed off to Kirk. Ellsworth broke a tackle, runs to his left, trying to find some daylight, and he picks up a couple of yards on his own there. Haynes makes the tackle. The linebacker, and it'll bring up a third down and long for Western Michigan. Third down and 6, call it. Off the Ball State, 43. Very good individual effort here by Kirk Ellsworth.
And Kirby picks up a yard. The Broncos going to have to burn a timeout right here.
Timeout Western Michigan. It's Ball State 7, Broncos nothing. We'll be back in a moment on the Bronco Radio Network.
It's 3 a.m., and as new moms and dads rock and hum and sway and soothe, they also wonder and worry.
Is the baby wet?
Hungry?
Do we need diapers?
With so many new things to worry about, don't let life insurance be one of them. Turn to someone who understands, your State Farm agent.
Had to call a timeout. Scores, Monty.
Well, I'll check the Mid-American Conference Finals for you. It was Central Michigan and Army today. The Chippewas win 14-10. Beat number 14 Wisconsin in a wild one. An old score, though, and Mid-American Conference games underway. Bowling Green in Ohio, Eastern Michigan in Toledo, and, of course, Ball State in Western Michigan.
Third down and 6.5, we'll call it. Trip set to the right. Robbie rolling to his right, looking downfield, swings it out to the right sideline for Scheffler. He will not get the first down. He's going to be a couple of yards short. Pulled out of bounds over there on the Broncos sideline at the 38. So it'll be a fourth down and two, and the Bronco punt team comes out. Fourth and two, and out comes Jim Laney.
Ellsworth is the up back right here.
Good note there. Fourth down and two. And they snap it back to Laney. High floating kick by Jim. Broncos hunt and fire down there. Catches it in the air at the 9-yard line where Ball State would take it. First and 10, leading 7-0.
Well, the Broncos get off to a good start, Robin. Really crisp in the first 4 or 5 plays of the series. The procedure call on the offensive lineman backed them up a little bit. And then Ball State tightened up its defense, and Western Michigan couldn't convert on a throw to the boundary to Tony Shepard.
So it's Ball State football. Their previous drive started deep in Western Michigan territory after the big kick return. Now they start at their own 9-yard line, leading 7-0 here with 10:15 to go in the first quarter. Lynch is under center. Hands it off to the tailback, and a little bit of daylight to the left, but then it closed in a hurry, and I think he lost a yard on the play as the Broncos pursuit of the football.
Tell you what, a lot of black shirts around there. So many that's hard to tell who made the tackle, but Austin Pritchard's there, Amir Ishmael's in there. I saw Duplo, small three linebackers getting to the action. The end on the front side of that play is Zach Davidson. He had to be a guy that turned the play inside. The Ball State carrier loses a yard, second and 11.
Second down and 11, they toss it to the tailback. And not much room over there, and no gain. Good pursuit again by the Bronco defense.
Paul Mersch running hard down the line of scrimmage. Davidson doing a great job at the point of attack. And a couple of those linebackers in there to mix it up. Western Michigan running extremely well to the football. Ball State did a great job in their first series of getting their running back to the corner with some pace and getting outside the tackle of the defensive end. The Broncos doing a much better job at the end position right now. They're going after Zach Davidson, and he's standing right in there.
Third down and 11 for Joey Lynch and the Ball State offense. They lead it 7-0, and Lynch back to throw. He had pressure right up the middle, and he throws it away, intended for Bostic, the tailback, out of the backfield. But heat right up the middle, and Lynch had to throw it away.
Tell you what, Western Michigan sends two linebackers into the same gap. The right guard is able to pick up, I think, Amir Ishmael, but Dustin Duclo isn't touched at all, Robin. He's the guy that absolutely hammers Joey Lynch into that Bronco end zone down there. Lynch is just trying to get rid of it before he gets killed, throws it away, and Ball State will have to punt from inside its 9. If I'm Western Michigan, I'm setting up a return for Greg Jennings right here.
Chris Miller to punt it away, averages 42.5 yards per punt, and a short kick fielded by Greg. He fumbled the football. It's loose, and I think the Broncos fall on it at the 40-yard line.
Boy, you don't see that every day where you have Greg Jennings not look a punt all the way in. What happens here, Robin, is he's got his hands down in the right spot, but he looked up to see where...
including the Russian National Ballet and David Copperfield. Go to ECCU1.org for the full listing of discounted shows. Isn't it great to be a member of ECCU?
In 1927, Western State Normal became known as Western State Teachers College and joined four other schools to form the Michigan Collegiate League. Mike Gary became Western's fifth head coach in the fall of 29 and coached the team through the 41 season, winning over 62% of his games. His 32 squad went 6-0-1 and was one of only 14 unbeaten teams that season.
Bronco fans, get together with ECCU.
7-0 Ball State. 8:50 to go in the first quarter. Trevon Riley's in the ballgame now as the running back. And Robbie Haas under center. Wide receivers left and right for Robbie. And he'll play fake and drop the throw. Going deep on the post to Greg Jennings. He's open. He's got it. Touchdown, Western Michigan. Greg Jennings on the post route. And Robbie Haas got tattooed after he let go of the pass. but the Broncos on the board and a point away from tying this one up.
Yeah, my concerns for Robbie. He absolutely got waylaid, but I'm telling you what, the Broncos go to the deep post on the left side to Greg Jennings. Robbie Haas threw that ball 50 yards on a dart. Let Jennings run underneath it. This one you think the Broncos can't go deep because it's not the starting quarterback. Haas let one fly.
That was a beautiful pass by Robbie. Led Greg Jennings perfectly on the post route. Threw that ball about 50 yards in the air, and now he is on his back after getting tattooed after the throw. And the Bronco medical team out there helps him to his feet, and he'll head to the sidelines on his own. Point after coming up from Nate Meyer.
Coach Cuban not happy over there on the far sideline, letting the linesman know that's a late hit on his quarterback.
Nate Meyer for the point after. Laney to hold. The spot is down. Laney's kick is up, and it is good. The Broncos strike with a 40-yard touchdown pass. Haas to Jennings. We're all tied at 7, and we're coming right back. This is the Bronco Radio Network.
Sprint and Nextel have joined together to form the new Sprint. And Rocom, your Sprint authorized representative, is here for you. Now you can have more choice and flexibility than with any other wireless company. Never pay huge overages again with our fair and flexible plan. If it's free incoming calls you're looking for, sign up for our free incoming plan. Offer ends November 12, 2005. New activation and...
Tie, and here's the kick by Nate Meyer, taken by Love at the goal line, and he is out to the 20-yard line, to the 21, maybe the 22, and that's it.
Tell you what, much better kick coverage here, and he knew he was having a really nice game early as Zach Davidson. He's made some great plays at defensive end. He's on the kickoff team for Western Michigan. Got off his block, reached out with his right arm, got to the legs of the ball carrier, the return man here for Ball State, and makes a fine tackle down there. Ball State's only going to start out at their 21-yard line. That's very good kick coverage, and we'll see what the Bronco defense can do on this series.
8:36 left in the first quarter. Broncos 7, Ball State 7. Cardinals with the football at the 21 of Ball State. Joey Lynch, ball on the right hash. They're working left to right in the white with a red trim. Numerals, and they hand it off to Hill, the tailback, and he's out just short of the 30-yard line. Antoine Allen makes the tackle.
Good-looking scheme here for Ball State, Robin. They offset the running back behind the left guard. He takes the handoff. They let the front side end for Western Michigan rush up the field into the backfield. Then they kick him out with a running back. That creates the running lane, and Hill has got some really good speed. Good close there by the Broncos secondary, but it's after an 8-yard gain.
Second down and 2 for Ball State. Bostic was the tailback in the last series. Hill's back in there now. And Joey Lynch under center. Broncos coming with a blitz. Lynch dumps it off underneath. And it's a first down out to the 35-yard line on the completion to the tight end. That's Darius Hill.
And a little dump down. Western Michigan went with the blitz. Picked up well by Ball State's running backs and offensive line. That allowed Lynch time to slip the ball to the flat to the big tight end. Antoine Allen, the safety, comes up. Makes a great open field tackle. But it's after a 5-yard gain. And Ball State's out to the 35.
Brandon Hawkins wide to the right side. Lewis Johnson wide left. Paxton and I this time behind Joey Lynch on first and 10 from the Ball State 35. Lynch play fake, back to throw. He wants to go deep over the middle. He's got a receiver and he overthrows him. Incomplete, intended for Lewis Johnson, who was 5 yards behind the Broncos secondary.
Well, he's coming off, but Johnson's coming off the left side of that Ball State offense. That's Kennard Banks, the Bronco freshman number 6, who's out there trying to be the cover corner. Johnson is well behind Kennard, and the Broncos fortunate that that Joey Lynch overthrows his wide receiver. Lewis Delmas, the other corner, was blitzing on the play, couldn't get there.
Moss wide to the left side. Steinhaus, the tight end, also wide left in a trip set. Now they shift. And Joey Lynch in the shotgun sends a man in motion out of the backfield. Dante Love and back to throw. Joey Lynch, pressure from the edge, dumps it off underneath. It's caught by Terry Moss, but he is buried for a loss back at the 32-yard line.
Tell you what, a lot of there's three different looks from Ball State trying to confuse this young Western Michigan defense on the play. First they go trips left, then they bring people in behind the backfield, then they send the guy in the backfield on motion to the right side. All the throw is screen pass that Western Michigan covers like a blanket. They lose yardage on the play. I noticed Belmonte was there, and I'm not sure who else, but there are three Broncos who got a piece of that tackle.
Biggers and Jimmy Vincent check into the ball game now. Third down and 14 for Ball State from the 31. Lynch is in the shotgun. We're tied at 7. Love in motion out of the backfield. Back to throw is Lynch. Stepped up in the pocket. He wants to go deep down the sideline. It's in the air and it is batted up and down and incomplete. Almost intercepted. E.J. Biggers and Jimmy Vincent on the cover.
Well, you know what? E.J. Biggers in the football game hasn't played a lot in the last 2 to 3 weeks. Lewis Delmas was out of the ball game. We'll take a look and see what might be wrong with Lewis. He's been in there virtually every snap short side of the field cover corner. Lynch going right after E.J. Biggers fresh into the game, and E.J. with really good corner coverage. And Jimmy Vincent in there almost got his hands on the football for an interception. Greg Jennings back to return the punt.
On to punt it away is Chris Miller. Here's his boot. It's a good one. Greg calls for the fair catch. Fields it at the 26. First and 10 from the Bronco 26-yard line. We're all tied at 7. 6:19 to go. Let's see if Haas comes in.
Hold your flicks, I'm not for the photo ops. It's black, gold name, y'all for Koto. Ock my twist like a ratchet in the auto shop. Since granddaddy, old DeSoto stopped and he got the caddy. I've been gladly serving. Any of y'all cats wanna act determined? Spit pesticides for rats and vermin. Seem like none of y'all chumps is burning. You're hopeless, and I'm a little better than dope is. Far from a brand new kid to show biz. Trying to hold on, maintain my...
That's all day long, baby.
For Jennings, he's going to throw off the right sideline. He's got a receiver down there, but it's picked off by Ball State at the 40-yard line and knocked out of bounds on the sideline, and we're going to get a flag for a late hit. And we have flags everywhere now, flags all over the place. Ball State able to come up with the pick. I think it was Trey Lewis picking it off.
Well, they're going to call Western Michigan for one of these personal fouls for a late hit on the sideline. But it looked to me as if the Bronco tackler fell down or got shoved into the guy who was running out of bounds. It didn't appear to me that he was diving to make a tackle 3 yards off the boundary. But we know this, one of them is going to be against the Broncos. The question is, what are the 14 other yellow hankies out there?
I think every guy out there threw a flag. Every guy on the field threw a flag there.
Yeah, I think you're right. There's a lot of yellow. This could take a while.
6:08 left to go in the first quarter. Ball State 7, Western Michigan 7, and let's get the call.
Red ball, personal foul, number 90 hand, number 75. Red ball, personal foul, number 80 hand, 78.
Two Bronco personal foul calls, Monty.
30 yards on the Broncos here, so that's going to put Ball State down to the Bronco, 18-yard line maybe? Guarantee you Coach Cubitt will not be happy about that. You know, it's strange. Didn't really get a chance to see it. I'm watching the ball out of bounds, but I understand the late hit on the boundary. The other one I didn't have a look at.
So Ball State will have great field position this time. Broncos went with the double pass, the quick pass behind the line of scrimmage to Greg Jennings, and then he was throwing one up the boundary, and it was picked off. It had a little too much air under it.
It had a lot of air under it, and I think that's credit to Ball State's defense. They got a lot of pressure on Greg. He's just trying to get rid of it and get it down the field. Big test for the Western Michigan defense right here.
With the penalties, the ball is placed at the 17-yard line of Western Michigan.
Now the Stripes still talking about some stuff here.
Our referee tonight, William Algie Jr. Trying to get a handle on this. Now we're ready. They leave it at the 17. First and 10, Ball State. We're tied at 7 at Waldo Stadium. Lynch, play fake, rolling out to his right. Wants to throw on the run. It's batted up in the air, and it is incomplete. C.J. Wilson batted that ball up in the air, and it was almost picked off.
Now, Lynch is rolling to his right here, Robin, trying to sneak the ball down the right seam. Lynch doesn't have the strongest arm. The ball floats a little bit. Broncos closing on the ball, on the receiver. Just as he gets his hands on it, he gets hit. The ball pops up into the air, and about three or four people on both sides of the football had a chance to get it.
Lynch, a 68% passer coming in, is 3 for 8 tonight for 25 yards. Lynch on the handoff. That Bostic to the 13-yard line. Austin Pritchard in on the tackle from his outside backer spot.
That's a gain of 5 for Ball State, Robin, but Western Michigan actually reacts to this play fairly well. Bostic gets hit after about a 2-yard gain, but is able to maintain his balance and dive forward for another couple yards to force his third down foul.
Wide to the right, Lewis Johnson. Tight on the left side, Darius Hill. Baxter and I. Steinhaus also in there at the tight end on the right. Play fake, Lynch to throw. Crashford, he dumps it off to the fullback. First down out of bounds at the 2. Completed to the fullback out of the backfield. That's Brad Sawyer, the fullback, on the reception.
I'll tell you what, that's a great job by Lynch, the quarterback for Ball State. He's got 2 Broncos bearing down in his face. He can't even really throw off his foot. Front foot, he slings that ball to the boundary to his fullback off 1 foot, and just a great individual effort there from the Cardinals quarterback.
First and goal, Ball State, put the football at the 4. They toss it back to Bostic. Bostic to his left into the end zone. Touchdown, Ball State. 13-7, Ball State on top after the 4-yard run by Bostic.
Now Ball State's converting on opportunities it's getting. Western Michigan with a turnover to start this drive for Ball State. Then 2 personal foul penalties on the same play puts them in the red zone. That puts Western Michigan's defense in a bad spot. The score will soon be 14-7, and both times Ball State has started their drive well into Western Michigan territory. Kind of hard to hold the defense responsible.
Ryan Jackson for the point after, it's good. 5:11 to go in the first quarter. Ball State 14, Western Michigan 7. This is the Bronco Radio Network.
Big ideas and office efficiency from TDS Metrocom. Big idea number 11, shortening all office memos to 7 words or less.
Sales bad. Try harder. Picnic on Saturday.
Or installing a new time clock with milk commentary.
So, late again, Ernie. Out playing poker with the guys till the wee hours. You wouldn't know a good hand if it bit you in the ass.
Better yet, try Business Essentials from TDS Metrocom. Start with unlimited local calling and all the features a growing business needs. Add unlimited long distance and top it off with TDS Metrocom's super fast internet service. Business Essentials does a heck of a lot more for your efficiency than, say, the turbo stapler.
How's this thing work? Oh, cool. Oh, no. Watch out.
Unlimited local and long distance plus high-speed internet. Build it the way you like with Business Essentials. Only from TDS Metrocom. Call 1-877-METROCOM or visit tdsmetro.com today. Some restrictions apply. Stop that. Call us for details.
Damon's dropping off the bridge here in the radio booth. Gotta love Damon.
Hey, they're awfully good.
High floating kick. Joe Gardner calls for the fair catch at the 30-yard line where Western Michigan takes over. First and 10 as Ball State goes to the boot kick. We got a flag back at the 41.
Well, there's only one thing that can be, and that's going to be offside on the Cardinals. So Bill Kubik can decide, does he want to have him re-kick it or take it at the 31 left hash?
Well, they're talking about it over there. Gonna make him do it again.
I guess not. I guess they're going to take the football.
Now, what they're going to do is they're marking off the 5-yard penalty.
Okay.
And they're going to give Western Michigan the ball at the 36 instead of the 31. Now, you got me on what they're doing. I thought the options there were take it where it is or take a re-kick.
5:11 left to go in the first half. Broncos will take it at the 36, so they mark off the 5-yard penalty, and Western Michigan will have it. Javon Riley in there at the running back spot. And Robbie Haas still at quarterback, hands it off to Trevon. No room there at the line of scrimmage. He lost a yard. Second down and 11 for Western Michigan.
Yeah, that play, Robin, doesn't even have a chance to get started. The Broncos are trying to lead block with one of the backside guard or the backside tackle. They get a kickout block there. The down tackle for Ball State, the nose guard, does a good job putting his body into that hole, and Trevon couldn't get started.
Chapel to the right, Jennings to the left. Now Greg's in motion to the right. He takes the handoff out of motion, working to his right, and he's wrestled down for a loss. He lost some yardage on the play. Ball State. Good play on defense.
And Cardinals playing with a lot of energy right now. They've got a 14-7 lead. I mean, we have to be realistic. They haven't really been in too many football games. So you know they were really pumped up about coming into this one here at Western Michigan against first-year head coach Bill Cubitt. And right now, the Cardinals are playing with a lot of momentum.
Broncos are going to go 5 wide, empty backfield, shotgun, third down and 11 for Western Michigan. They trail it 14-7. Haas to throw, going to the sideline, and it is incomplete. Caught out of bounds on the sideline by Kelly Martin over there on the far sideline, so it'll be incomplete, and the Broncos will have to punt it away with Jim Leaney.
Now the Broncos go 5 wide, which is empty. Ball State dropped 8 into coverage, and the sad part about it is for the Broncos is Kelly Martin was wide open on the far boundary. Robbie Haas simply overthrew him, and the Broncos will have to punt it away. I mean, Kelly Martin has no Cardinal within 10 yards of him.
Kelly caught the ball, but he was out of bounds when he made the reception. Laney to punt it away. Oh, and he turns one over. Thundering punt. All the way back. It hits the return man and goes into the end zone. That's a live ball, and he goes out of the back of the end zone. Now they're going to call it a touchback. 65-yard punt by Jim Laney. That was a bomb. And the return man got a hand on it, and then it bounced in the end zone. The Broncos were trying to chase down that live football.
Yeah, they certainly were. And
.342 to go, 14-7, Ball State.
I'm confused on my rules tonight. If the return man touches the ball, it's a live football. It's a fumble.
That's right. And then it went through the back of the end zone, so they'll take it on the 20.
So it should be a safety.
Lynch. Well, I don't think they really had control. Up the right side, this is the tailback, DJ Hill. And now we get another flag flying in there.
Another late hit on the boundary, no doubt. Western Michigan needs to regain its poise here. Got a great punt from Laney, and then 19 yards on the first play from scrimmage, plus a dead ball foul, likely to go against the Broncos. That one's going to go against Kennard Banks, and the Broncos coaching staff has him over at the bench talking to him about it. That's the third personal foul of the football game against Western Michigan, maybe even the fourth, not even out of the first quarter yet. And I called everyone's attention that usually these things are a two-way street, and unless it's a late hit on the boundary, it's usually the second guy gets caught in a scrum, but the Broncos have had 2 late hits on the boundary, which is not acceptable. You've got to learn to lay off when that guy's out of bounds.
Brandon Hawkins and Lewis Johnson wide to the left side. Tight end Steinhaus tight on the left. One setback behind Lynch. That's Bostic, and he's got it into the middle. And he crosses the 45 to the 44-yard line. And they're going to get him to the 43. 3-yard gain. Second down and 7. They're in Western Michigan territory, leading the Broncos 14-7.
Watching a lot of the antics here at the end of the plays, and I see lots of Broncos talking to the umpire, which says to me that there's some stuff happening after the whistle. that is upsetting the Broncos. They've got to learn to keep their poise and play through that.
Lam and Barcatapane inside with Belmonte and Zach Davidson on the ends up front. Play fake by Lynch. He's back to throw. Sets up, throws, and it is caught by Bostic out of the backfield, and he's hit as he reaches the 39-yard line. Broncos cover it well over there as Amir Ishmael and Lewis Delmas are in on the tackle along with Pritchard.
Now it's really good downfield coverage here for Western Michigan secondary because Lynch would like to go down the field to one of the wide receivers. Both up and covered by the corners for the Broncos. So he's got to hit a check down route on the far side of the field. Great coverage by the Broncos to come in and put a tackle on the football to force a third down three.
Third and three. Johnson wide right. Hawkins wide left. Now Johnson in motion. Broncos coming with pressure. Lynch back to throw. Steps up. Pressured. He's going to run with it. He's got the first down. He's down to the 20-yard line. First and 10 for Ball State.
My goodness, Western Michigan has Joey Lynch in a position where he can't find a receiver down the field. Unfortunately, the Broncos aren't able to keep contained on the far side of the field. Anthony Belmonte with a superhuman effort to try to get to the quarterback Lynch. To be honest with you, he couldn't get there because he was dragged down by the tight end on his way into the quarterback. That all goes for naught. Lynch with a terrific scramble has Ball State inside the Western Michigan red zone.
First and 10 Cardinals for the Broncos. 13, they lead it 14-7. Here's the toss. This is Hill. He's inside the 10, down to the 8-yard line. B.J. Hill with a 5-yard run.
Ball State just powering at Western Michigan right now. The Broncos really, they're scrambling on defense at this point in the football game. Everything they've tried to do in terms of pressure in the last three or four attempts hasn't gotten to the quarterback Lynch. Then when they do get him out of his comfort zone, get him scrambling, he takes off and runs for a 30-yard gain. Ball State, the biggest problem right now is they're getting 4 and 5 yards a carry on first down.
Hawkins and Johnson wide right. They toss left to Hill to the short side. He's down to the 5 into the end zone. Touchdown, B.J. Hill. They toss it to the short side, and Hill carries it in through traffic.
And the Broncos digging themselves a hole early in this one, Robin. Ball State is just going with big, with power football. Two tight end, hammering it right at Western Michigan. That's two toss sweeps to the left side in a row, and they picked up 19 yards or 15 yards in those two carries. And the Bronco defense is really struggling at this point in the game.
And Jackson on for the point after attempt here. Trying to make it 21-7 Ball State. The holder is Ryan Patrick. He got it down. Jackson got it up and through. 1:03 left in the first quarter. Ball State 21, Western Michigan 7. This is the Bronco Radio Network.
Run through it. Yeah, yeah. Okay. No, I think it's sold out, actually. Let me just start like that. Whoa! Are you guys rolling on this?
Yeah. That's a 90-footer.
Oh, that is amazing. Oh, my. Did you get that? You have that, right?
Here's the kick by Ball State. And it bounces at the 8. It's picked up by Chauncey at the 5 to the 10 to the 15. Chauncey out across the 20. Tompkins out just short of the 30-yard line where Western Michigan will take over. First and 10, trailing 21-7.
Now, Western Michigan's offense, Robin, needs to do its part here. I know they've scored one touchdown, but the combination of a turnover and poor kick coverage is two of the three scores for Ball State. Put that defense for Western Michigan on a short field. That's a tired defense. They just got run over there by Ball State in that last series. looked like they were awfully tired. The offense can really help with that by driving the ball down the field, finding a way to get some points, and burning up a little bit of play clock.
Haas still in at quarterback. Javon Riley is the running back. Chapel to the left. Jennings is in a slot to the right. Robbie's changing the play on first and 10 from the 29. Straight drop back to throw. Swings it out to Chapel. He makes the catch. It was a low throw. He had to go down and get it, and he stumbles forward for a gain of about 3 to the 32-yard line. Second and 7 on the catch by Joe Chapel.
Now Robbie Haas has made a couple of really nice throws, and he's made a couple that he wish he has back, and that last pass falls in that category. It's a super effort by Chapel to go down and pick this one off the top of his shoelaces. If Robbie is able to hit Joey up around his numbers, Chapel's actually got some green space to run.
Tony Shepler's lined up wide to the left side. Jennings and Chapel wide right. Chavon's the setback. Second and 7 from the 32. And they try the swing pass. Ball was batted down. It's a lateral, and it's a touchdown for Ball State. Touchdown, Ball State. The ball was knocked down by Martin Dunmore, the defensive end. Picks it up and carries it in for a score. 27-7, Ball State.
Well, this is a play, Robin, that this is reviewable, obviously, in the Mid-American Conference replay, but I don't know whether that's a forward pass or not. Seemed to me it was a backward pass.
But I think we're going to get a review here. This will be the first review here at Waldo Stadium. We're going to review whether that was a forward pass or a lateral. That was really close.
That was borderline. I don't think we're going to have enough evidence to overturn the call on the field, which means Ball State has opened up close to an insurmountable lead here in the first quarter.
Yep. And the Broncos came out, and these penalties have hurt them, Monty, and we haven't seen the Broncos take.
Frustrating to be behind on the scoreboard. It's even more frustrating when you know that at least two of the scores have been a direct result of penalties that have put Ball State on a really short field offensively.
27-7, Ball State. This last touchdown under review, though. Ball State opened the scoring after a 54-yard kickoff return, a 21-yard touchdown pass to Dante Love. Broncos answered with a touchdown pass of 40 yards from Haas to Jennings. And Larry Bostic carried one in from 4 yards out. And another touchdown to Hill. An 8-yard run by B.J. Hill. And we'll see if this touchdown stands as it's under review as to whether or not the pass was a forward pass or a lateral. Knocked down by Martin Dunbar, the defensive end, and returned into the end zone for a touchdown.
You know, part of the problem with, not problem, but one of the issues with replay is you only get a couple of angles. And really, to be able to tell whether this was a forward pass or not, you pretty much have to be at the line of scrimmage. And so, because the camera will be at an angle, whichever way they look at it, my guess is this call on the field stands as a touchdown, but we shall find out.
Well, Brady Hoke, the head coach at Ball State, played his college football at Ball State, but during his coaching tenure, spent a few years here in Kalamazoo on the staff of Jack Harbaugh. So he's walked up and down the sidelines of Waldo Stadium more than once. And they hammered Western Michigan a year ago, 40.